I have with me Swamiji Sunishthanandaji. Swamiji, welcome to our show. Vivekananda is someone we have heard a lot, and we know that his preachings are being practiced all over the world. If you can tell us about the life and achievement of Swami Vivekananda himself.
Swami Vivekananda, just to speak on him, before speaking on him, just the background I want to speak, or the background on which Swami Vivekananda was born. So Swami Vivekananda was actually the disciple of Sri Ramakrishna.
Yes.
Actually, his entire life and his teaching is based on the teachings and the life of Sri Ramakrishna.
Right.
So Swami Vivekananda's first, we notice him first in the Parliament of Religions. That's where he became world famous. But before that, he has attended another Parliament of Religion, we can say. That's the life of Sri Ramakrishna itself was a Parliament of Religion.
Okay.
That's what Swami Vivekananda used to say.
Mm-hmm.
That the life of Sri Ramakrishna itself is a Parliament of Religion. Because in that life, we will find that in a span of 12 years, he himself had practiced all the religions.
Right.
And that's a great Ramakrishna Sri Ramakrishna Paramahamsa. So there he practiced all the religions, and it's not just a matter of doctrine and dogma. It was through his practice he realized that each and every religion takes us to the same goal.
Right.
And that's the main message of Sri Ramakrishna. Just sitting under his feet, Swami Vivekananda actually was inspired with this message. There
is
two messages actually. This one is that all the paths lead to the same goal, all religions are true. And another is that divinity is in each and every being. The God has become the entire universe. The entire universe is permeated with the divinity. So to serve man is to serve God. So these are the two pillars of the mission, Ramakrishna mission, which Swami Vivekananda propounded throughout the world. So that's the thing we find that in India, when he was moving around as a wandering monk, so there we find that seeing the downtrodden condition of the masses, the degraded condition of the mass, so he felt that there is a need to go to the West. First, his intention to go to the West was different, just to improve the condition of the nation of India. That was his first intention.
Right.
Because it was in such a degraded condition, he wanted some economical help actually. But after going to the West, he found that it's the West also is in need of some spirituality. Eastern spirituality is in need. Because of the material civilization, outwardly it looks, it's full of pomp and valor. So inside he found that something is lacking.
Right.
That the search for life, the meaning of life, there is a bit of depression. And that's where the Swamiji's role is very important. So that's the point which Swami Vivekananda is stressing. That God's creation is unique. All are different. We are all different. We are having different temperaments. We are having different inclinations. So there cannot be a single doctrine, a single religion which suits all. Each and everyone, according to his temperament, according to his background, according to the place he has taken birth, according to his society, he will have his own inclinations, own temperament, and he has full freedom to follow his own choice, his own way of understanding. So actually we are not traveling from error to truth, we are traveling from lesser truth to higher truth.
Right.
Everything is true. It's very nice way of telling. It's a very broad vision. So that's the thing, that actually this oneness doesn't mean in any way uniformity. That's not it's not speaking of any one doctrine which should be imposed on all.
Okay. Well, I think his preachings, that is, there is every human being is potentially divine, and also that there are so many pathways, unity in diversity, which you said, which is very applicable for a multicultural society like Australia, where you have the freedom of religion, freedom of expression, freedom of language. Therefore, Swami Vivekananda's preachings, would you say, is very relevant to the Australian society?
Australian society and the entire global world, I can say, it's very relevant.
And of course, in today's world, which is torn apart by mistrust amongst people, terrorism and you name it, so many other mishaps which have been happening in this world. How relevant is Vivekananda's preaching today in today's world?
Swami. Apparently, it seems the world is torn apart by violence, but the actual fact, as we observe, is just the opposite.
Mm-hmm.
The group who are so-called having the narrow vision are gradually getting diminished. They are finding their existence is as if almost stifled. And that's why they are actually getting desperate. In society, more and more people you will find, why this yoga and meditation are much more prevalent now? Because people have started, what you say, losing faith on any organized religion. Swami Vivekananda used to say very nicely, whenever two person organize to form a religion, they start hating the third person. So this, it's not the organized religion which is prevailing now. Each and every individual somehow has the tendency to have his spirituality in his own way. So that's why we find this meditation, yoga, all these things. So here there is somehow that approach is there, that I can have my spirituality in my own way. That is very much prevailing. And that's why those who are having this narrow beliefs, they are finding that we are losing grounds and they are becoming desperate. And this violence and all is just the outcome of that desperate attitude of a very minor group.
Mm.
It's not the, the opinion or it's the temperament of the majority. The majority are actually, this violence is actually the outcome of the opposite fact, that majority is becoming more and more acceptable, they are more cooperative and all to the other beliefs.
Mm-hmm. And would you say that this play, which is coming up on the 17th and 18th of September at Opera House, is going to reflect those sentiments of Swami Vivekananda, remind us and the world today that the preachings of Swami Vivekananda are extremely important in today's world?
Is that the mission? That's the mission. That's the thing. Main thing we are going to stress.
Mm-hmm.
This play is really unique.
If there is one message you want to send out to our viewers who want to obviously get involved in, participate in this talk as well as the play, what would that be, Swamiji?
So that's just as we learn writing by writing over the writing of our parents. You know, when we started learning our writing and all, our parents wrote A, B, C, D on some paper and we just scribbled over that.
Mm-hmm.
And then we learned writing. So we need not think of some new philosophy, new way of life.
Mm-hmm.
It is already there. It is written by these great personalities like Swamiji. Let us just scribble over it.
Mm.
I think our goal will be achieved.
Swamiji, thank you very much for coming on our show and enlightening us.
Thank you. Thank you.